Shane McMahon is really playing some mind games with Kurt Angle, but the Olympic great has challenged Shane O'Mac for the King of the Ring. Will the Boy Wonder accept? Kaientai, next up here at Tag Team Action.
Boy, I think Shane is treading on dangerous ground, Kevin Kelly.
Well, he certainly really got in Kurt Angle's grill this past week. Talk about it here in a few moments. Wait a minute.
The mic?
Where did he get that microphone from?
He's evil. He's magic.
Watch this.
Hey, you two in the ring. We are Kaientai. And our goal tonight is to come down to that ring and show everybody exactly why we are evil.
Taka's got a head cold.
Or been drinking a lot of whiskey.
We'll see if Funaki is cursed with the same affliction.
Indeed.
I swear Funaki looks like a Japanese goldfish.
Well, it will be Taka and Funaki against Greg Pawluk and Rob McManus. Tag Team Action next up here on Metal. We were talking about Kurt Angle and Shane McMahon with, of course, Shane McMahon a couple of weeks ago on Raw interrupting Kurt's gold medal winning reenactment ceremony and paying the price for it. But Shane has not stopped in aggravating the Olympic gold medalist.
And not only aggravating the Olympic gold medalist Kurt Angle, Shane is also aggravating his father, Mr. McMahon. I mean, Lance Storm, a WCW competitor, entering a WWF ring.
Cost Perry Saturn a victory, perhaps over Steve Blackman Monday on Raw. We know Lance is from Calgary, lives in town, and how opportunistic of Shane to place a phone call to Lance.
Are you implying that possibly, since there are some WCW guys that live in Minneapolis, this is going to happen on Raw?
I wouldn't want to speculate, but you know what? I guess everybody, especially Kurt Angle, should have their eyes peeled at all times as Greg Pawluk takes down Funaki. Nice head scissors. Tag made. His partner, Rob McManus, enters the contest next. Shane, of course, was there were reports of a limousine circling around the arena Thursday on SmackDown, and all the security was on high alert for Shane O'Mac's appearance at ringside during Kurt Angle's matchup with Y2J.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Spike Dudley shows up and costs Angle the match with Y2J.
Oh,
man, nice move.
Pancake move there by McManus, takes down Taka. I got to ask the question, Michael. Do you think Shane was instrumental in Spike Dudley being there in the right place at the right time?
Oh, well, it does look like more.
Here's a cover. Count, two count only.
More than a coincidence, but why would Shane O'Mac hang out with a little puke like Spike Dudley?
Well, I don't know. I know Molly Holly certainly is sweet on Spike, and I think the feeling is reciprocated. He likes her. He really likes her. You got to love the story of Spike and Molly. Come on.
I don't like love. Okay, I'm not into love. I'm lust.
Well, listen, Spike and Molly. Spike likes Molly. He admitted it, and he really paid the price. What a heroic, what a chivalrous gesture Monday on Raw as he took the brunt of the blow as Molly was driven through the table. Bubba Ray Dudley followed through on his promise to put Molly through a table.
And what a blow that must have been.
Knife edge shot there as Greg Pawluk. Listen, people.
Evo, Evo. Next for Kaientai, their own show.
I don't know. Uh-oh. Greg Pawluk in a bad place. Oh, what impact. Michael, I'm a little bit disturbed by some of the images we saw this past week at the World Wrestling Federation when it came to The Undertaker's wife, Sarah. What a mysterious situation. It all began with JR receiving a letter early in the afternoon at Raw.
I don't understand that situation whatsoever. That is, like, weird. And it's, in my opinion, and I know I'm a little out there, that is going way too far.
Well, a very creepy video. On Raw, we saw The Undertaker's wife, Sarah, in a very deep and dark-sounding voice, and a lot of questions to be answered. We know history says don't mess with The Undertaker's family. Stone Cold Steve Austin paid the price at one time for going that route with Dead Man Inc. I've got to wonder, what has got to be going through The Undertaker's mind?
I don't know. And we also saw something else on Raw as far as Sarah and The Undertaker.
Wait a minute.
I'm sorry, on SmackDown.
Well, of course, SmackDown, we saw The Undertaker and his wife four-wheeling, you know, enjoying some time off with The Undertaker and this mysterious view of family life. And, man, very disturbing. Taka Funaki beginning now to open up on Greg Pawluk. They have isolated Pawluk, separated him from his partner, showing what they could do as a tag team. Reversal of the Irish whip. Funaki, oh, wait a minute. Duck one clothesline, and both men clothesline each other. Pawluk and Funaki are both down. We will see Edge a little bit later in singles action. Michael Christian on the shelf following TLC 3 over a week ago on SmackDown.
Yeah, but Christian is very resilient. I expect him back soon.
Boy, Rob McManus comes in after receiving the tag. House of Fire. And now, Taka and Funaki are on the receiving end. Young men stepping up to the challenge here, taking a Kaientai. And now they got McManus set up. Uh-oh. A little miscommunication there from the personification of evil. Taka up on the shoulders, hurt Cabrana. No, sir. Is it enough? Two. Oh, so close. That would have been a huge upset.
Come on, Taka. If you're ever going to make it, you have to prepare yourself for everybody.
Oh, there's the Michinoku driver. You don't get up from that, this one is over.
I think Kaientai underestimated these kids, Kevin Kelly.
That's a mistake you cannot make, like you said, Michael. You want to be one of the top teams here in the World Wrestling Federation. Taka and Funaki enjoy victory here on Metal. We're going to take you back to SmackDown. We'll relive the highlights of an incredible World Wrestling Federation Championship match between Stone Cold Steve Austin and Chris Benoit. And we'll show you how Mr. McMahon played a role in that contest as well.